I actually had read an article about kids not seeing themselves in math class, and because they weren't seeing themselves in math class, they were feeling disconnected. And then I went to a speaker, a civil engineer from Turkey, and she talked about how representation is important and how she had looked into engineering and math, and she'd asked them, you know, what kind of person becomes a math teacher or researcher? What person becomes an engineer? And she found that overwhelmingly, it's what media portrays those people to be. So engineers tended to be Howard Wolowitz, and mathematicians are Einstein, and there wasn't a lot of room for people who weren't that really specific person to connect. As a woman in engineering, I didn't see people who looked like me. My professors didn't look like me. I was proud because I felt like a rogue, but I could definitely see how somebody would feel disconnected. So I got to thinking about how I could do something in my own room, because I'm always telling kids that if you do math, you're a math person, and that's just how it goes. At the end of the year, I was having juniors and seniors fill out a pretty simple bio and do a presentation about a person from history, and I let them pick. My students of color, they picked mathematicians who were also people of color, and the women tended to pick other women. And then this last summer, to kind of break up the monotony that is Facebook right now, I just started posting mathematicians. And as I did it, my friends started messaging me and telling me how much they enjoyed reading about all these different mathematicians. And then another friend told me that I should try to expand it out to more than just my friends on Facebook. And that's kind of where the Instagram was born.